फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ नियति चौहान, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल. अवर सब्जेक्ट इज इंडस्ट्रियल डेटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड कंट्रोल सिस्टम. चैप्टर 2, ECS बेसिक पैकेजेस. इन टूडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग टॉपिक द कंट्रोल कंसोल इक्विपमेंट, verifier devices and displays. We know that peripheral devices and displays are part of the control console equipment. We know that components of high level operators interface, video display, keyboard and peripheral devices. In peripheral devices, displays, group display, overview display, detail display, graphic display and trend display and alarm reporting. So let's start from group display. The group display show the operating parameters of 8, 12 or 16 control loops arranged in row so that they look like the faces of instruments on an instrument panel. Figure show 8 unit group display. So you can see in graph different processes are running in plant, right? PIC, that means pressure indicator and controller, TIC, that means temperature indicator and controller, okay? Then AIC, alarm indicator and controller. So for different process, we have a given instrument tag number. You can see at top side 701, 704, okay, 705. And for different process, we have a distributed, right, through tag number. So here you can see process value, set point value and percentage value and its unit. We can see here. So here we have a given one example of level indicator and controller. Okay. So in graph, we can see set point value, set point limit, deviation, output value and output limit you see in graph, right? And at last we can see process value, set point value and its percentage value. So this is group display and we can see all control loop and its value here. And group can be 8, 12 and 16 according to the process variable. Each of control loop is represented by a rectangular with bar graphs to indicate the values of the process variable and the output signal. So here we can see in graph total 8 control loops are available. A moving index position beside the process variable, bar show the set point and output percent are printed in or below the rectangular area. So we can see here process value, set point value and percentage value. The process variable value range may be printed on the left or right side of the bar graph. Okay, so we can see value of process variable at left hand side or right hand side. Several lines of text permit a tag number and service description to be shown, right? Some lines for text and tag number you can see at top side, right? Here given number and some description also given at top side, right? The rectangular may be change color usually to red if an error condition occurs, right? So here, if our this rectangular show red color if an error condition occurs. The arrays of rectangular reassemble the row of instrument on panel board of analog controller, right? So here we can rearrange our process variable. We can change its order to requirement. It can be used in the same way from keyboard. An operator can select a loop, select an operating mode, choosing between automatic, manual or cascade. Change set point value and change output values. So operator can change set point value and output value according to the requirement. In group display, most helpful is the capability to change the format of loop arrangement or even to change the content of the display. So we can change order of loop, right? And we can also change content of the display. This can be done from the keyboard by procedure called configuration. So this procedure can be say configuration. This permits any combination of loops arranged by process association, LRM priority, sequential operation, or any other common parameters to be included in same group display. In group display, the screen by repeated pressing of a keyboard button. Next, overview display. The overview display shows the without covering a number of groups, each group in a separate rectangular. A typical overview display will show 12 groups, although some suppliers show more or less. So here in overview display, we can see whole process in one screen. So in this overview display, we can take 12 group or we can take more than 12 group. The set point is shown as a straight line reference. Deviation of process variable. Deviation, that means variation. Variation of process variable from set point appearance as vertical bar. So in overview display, reference line can be represented as a horizontal line, and deviation of process variable can be shown as a vertical line. If a group display has 8 loop in a row, the reference line will have 8 segments. So here, if our group display has 8 control loop, right? So we can show up all group display here in one row. Here you can see overview display of whole process, okay? And here vertical line, that is for deviation, and horizontal line as a reference line. If the process variable for particular loop is greater than set point, a vertical line will rise up out the reference line from segment corresponding to that particular loop. Okay. If process variable less than or greater than set point value, then so we can see in vertical line. If the deviation is in other direction, a vertical line will drop down from the segment. So here, see in graph, if process variable has a less than or greater than value of set point, then we can see in vertical line, right? If values are positive, then we can show in upward direction. If value less than, then we can show it in downward direction. If the process variable is a set point value, there will be no vertical line. Digital condition can also be displayed on an overview display. Discrete conditions, an open or closed switch, can be shown as the presence or absence of a bar using from the reference line. Sequence can be changed in overview display. If the overview display indicates an alarm condition in a particular group and the group parameter must be examined more closely, the operator can frequently call off the group display. In today's session, I have discussed about group display and overview display. Remaining three displays we will discuss in next session. Thank you for watching video. If you have any query, then you can ask me.